Greetings from Gibberish Technologies. With Form Builder Plus, it is super easy to build Google Forms from any of your content. Your content could be a Google Doc, Sheets, Slide, Drive files, or other forms, or even a Gmail message or calendar event. Whatever it is and whatever format it is in, you can simply use Form Builder Plus to build Google Form from it by simply importing it. This video is focusing on building Google Forms from your Google Sheets with few clicks. If you have not yet installed Form Builder Plus, you can install it from Google Workspace Marketplace that is here. Once you have installed Form Builder Plus, you will see a small icon here coming as Form Builder Plus. You can open that directly from your Google Sheet. And for this demo, I'm going to use the sample template that comes with the Google Sheet. So let's open that. This is a sample template. This has the questions that you want to import that into Google Form. Let's have a close look at what columns it is having. It has a question, any images that goes with the question, and what type of field it is, whether it is required or not required. What are the options in case if it is selection type like multi-choice, drop-down, or checkboxes, or any of these selection type, then it has an information about the options that are available, the starting of the options up to the ending of the options, all these columns, and then a description. And if there is an other thing, means other option needs to be enabled. If there is an other option needs to be enabled, then the points for this particular question, if it is a quiz, we can assign a point for this. And what is the correct answer if it is a multi-choice selection or any selection type thing? What is the correct answer? And what should be the feedback given to the user if the user selects the correct answer? And what should be the URL shown to the user if the user chooses correct answer? Similarly, if the user chooses incorrect answer, what feedback to be given, what URL to be shown. So all this information that has been there in this sample template for you to quickly go ahead and configure it. So if you look at that, each of the row corresponds to one field or one questions in the Google form. So let's quickly look into that. What are the different types? The different types for your convenience, it is listed here. So that is picked up from this reference. So you can directly type in or you can choose from here. So the first one, this is the title of the form, and the student information is a section header. And this one, if you have not chosen any type, it is simply taken as a text field. And let's look at this. This has a question and an image there. An image has a caption. Image is a HTTP URL. And then this is a multi-choice question, and which is a required question, so that means the user cannot ignore it. And it has options here, and options also has the name of the option and what is the image to be attached to the option. And if you closely watch this, after the image there is a next section. So on choosing this, the user will be going into the next section. This is the conditional branching which Google Forms supports. So if you look at that, the second option, if he is choosing, he will be going into maths section. So maths is a section here. So likewise, you can point to any of the section, or you can say restart form, or you can say next section. Let's look at something else. We'll see there is a checkbox that is available here, a similar kind of information that we can put it here. And there's a checkbox grid. If there's a checkbox grid, then you need to use a comma separated values to show what are the rows and what are the columns. And then there's a scale type which is supported. You can watch that how it is, how the input is formatted. there's a paragraph which is supported here, there's a video which is supported. If there's a video type question is given, the option should be saying that the video image URL. So this is pretty much all the possible options here. If you closely watch this template, this will give an example of all possible things that you can do with Google Sheets. So you can copy this template and then change whatever you want. Once you have done all these changes and be it ready, then you can click on Form Builder Plus and click on Start. And say I want to take the sheet, question sheet, this is the sheet, and I want to take the full range. I want to consider this as a quiz, and I need to tell that which column is for what. So if it contains the headers, Form Builder Plus tries to identify things automatically by the name of it. It will go and identify those columns. If it is question, it will put that as a column for question. It identifies the image for the question. It identifies options, column types, descriptions, answer options, whether it is required or not, whether other option is chosen or not. All these columns it gets automatically identified if there is a header for this Google Sheet, and you tick this, it gets automatically identified. So once it is identified, you can go ahead and click on Get. So it goes and reads all this information and formulates questions for it. These are the questions it has formulated. It has taken 31 questions. You can open this and see all these questions here. You can also click on Preview to see a quick preview before actually importing the questions into it. So this is the quick preview. So you see that the title is coming here as title, the sections are coming correctly, the type which is not mentioned by default is coming as a text field, as a short answer. Then if you look at this, this is a multi-choice question which has question, image for the question itself, and then images for the answer options itself. So all these things are possible. In the preview also, you can do some adjustments based on the controls given here. You can watch another video which has full description about how the preview works. So let's go ahead with all this kind of things. You can have a quick look at it and then say that, okay, this is all fine. Maybe I'll just say that, okay, I will click this. This is the correct answer. I'm marking this as a correct answer. And then I'm confirming these changes. So whatever changes that you have made in this preview form, that gets back into this area and it is now ready to be imported. So let me go ahead and create a Google form and then import all these questions into the Google form. Click on create. So the name is, I'll keep the name as same. The form is now created. You can navigate to the form. The form will be currently empty because we have not imported any of these questions yet. So you can go back here and see what is to be imported. So it says that click on import to import the questions into this. All those 31 questions, if you want to import, we need to click on this import button. So now it's done. So all these 31 questions are imported successfully into your Google form. You can open this and see that all these questions as defined in the Google Sheet are imported here with the types correctly identifying that information. You can see that the question, the image, question image, and the answer options and the images for the answer options, everything is getting loaded. So you can verify your form. once you verify and then you're comfortable with that, you can send this as a quiz for your students or your audience or whoever you want to send this. So it is that simple and easy to create Google Forms from any of your Google Sheets simply by importing all this information directly into this. Using this, you can build a big question bank, and then you can use some controls like the selections. So for example, here you can randomly select the questions. So let's say you have 200 questions configured here, you want to pick random 10 questions, you can do that. You can do a randomize, it'll select 10 questions randomly, and then you can import that. If you look at this random selection here, so when you do import, it will pick up the random questions that has been selected here. So keep exploring all these other controls that are available here, and this is the simplest way you can build a Google form without having to do a copy paste or without having to type in the questions in Google Forms, but simply prepare that in a Google Sheet and reuse it to build Google Forms whenever you need one. Thank you for watching.